Okay, so here I can able to log into this PC directly like this. Okay, so without a domain controller, I am logging here. Okay, so how can I log in? So when I receive a TGT, when I receive a TGT from the server, so the TGT and ST stored here. And as per the group policy, default group policies, okay, is there now? So default domain policies, default domain controller policy. So as per that one also, you can see user authentication policies. You can see there, you can find this TGT, how long it will store. How long it will store? Already I told it is a 10 days. That's why I can able to log in without this one. To log into this PC, what we required? First ticket granting ticket and service ticket. If in case domain controller is not available, but this information already in the PC, so I can able to log in. So that is the point I want to include in the previous video, but I am unable to do it. Okay, next new one. Same thing only. Here, when I type login, I log in with this user and immediately log in without a domain controller. So how come? Because yesterday, day before yesterday, domain controller is there and I log in with this user only. So when I log in with this user ticket granting ticket and service ticket stores in this PC inside internally. So in a temporarily only it stores. But when I log out and or shut down the PC, this stores in this PC only. Even though if I don't have a domain controller on, so I can able to, I can able to log into PC. That's why I can able to get it. Okay, so I want to test this one like this. Already I log in. Even I disconnected, my IP address is also wrong. Also, I can do it. Now what I'm going to do is, I am before going to that one, so I want to verify a few things. One is, what is my computer name, current name? So CTS2 WinC1, that is a current name, okay? And also I have to verify my compmgmt.msc. Okay, it may open or not, we don't know. As a domain admin, it may get it. Okay, so I will go to users and computers. How many users are there? Can you see? This is my user. Student one is actually local administrator. Can you see why this Sirisha, Pavani, IT user one, IT user two not showing here? Because it is a local computer. Okay, this is a local computer, local computer users. So those are domain users are login, right? This is a local computer users. Okay, now I will tell you two, three points, then I will record again. So first of all, I'm logging out. Just I'm sign out or shut down, restart anything, no problem. So immediately if I click here, can you see the user is showing here? If I go to other user and type Sirisha password, it may not be login, but I don't give a chance. I will go to IT user one, which is login earlier. So first time we use that one, I'm giving password. It is logging, which is we logging because of that TGT store. Okay, if I try to log in with a new user, it won't log in. So that's the thing actually. I may have any user without a previously login user, that is important. Users, I agree with IT user 2, Sirisha and Pawnee. I think I didn't log in with I didn't remember the other users. Anyway, guys, anybody remember HR? I created two accounts. ITI user, Java, I created some users. Anybody remember that usernames?
IT user
1, IT user 2. I already log into this PC. So it is logging directly. It should not log in like that. It should not log in, but it is logging. This is having some issues. First time logging. So for example, I am putting Sai Charan. I didn't create it, right? So which one I created, I also already remember. Siddiq. Really. Ajit, I think. Ajit, I created. Now it is showing. We cannot sign in. This is the error I want. Okay. So we can't sign in you in this with this credential because your domain is not available. Make sure your device is connected to your organization's network and try again. If you previously signed on this device with other credential, you can sign in with that credentials. Okay, so already whatever the users are logging to this PC, I can log in because their ticket granting ticket and everything is shown here only. But if I try to log in with a new user or the user which is not yet log into this PC, that also cannot log in. Why? Because of first time the request has to stand, TGT should be assigned, and service ticket should be assigned to this PC to access. So it is not there, we can't able to log in. So what is this meaning? Your domain controller is offline. Very good. Now I don't want my domain controller, I want to log into my local account. Means which account? Student one account. I want to log in. How to log in with a normal account? So that is a second part. So for this one, we should remember what account you already log in, that is a student one. Okay, and second, and computer name is also important. Computer name and username and username password. So username, local your account name is student one, computer name is DTS to win C1. This is my computer name. Next, what is the password for this one? I didn't remember it. Password. Student one password is maybe Vedic@123. So we'll see that one. So how to log in? So when you log into domain, so you are telling it it's a domain name, right? When you log into local PC, you have to log in like a CTS to win C1/student1. So what is this? Login with a local account, because that is a computer name. I'm logging to computer name, not a domain name. I'm logging to my computer with a computer name. I'm logging. Okay, if I log in like this, if the account is showing like this, or I log in like this, what is the thing? I log in to domain user, because this is a domain name. So Vedic.com is a domain name and this is a domain user. So if I want to log in with the domain name, so domain name slash username. So that is a difference. Other user. So I'm logging to student one. So if I put a student one, can you see it is still signed into Vedic one only? If you confuse with what is the computer name and all, I will give you one simple idea. Type administrator. When you type administrator, you can see the bottom, that is your computer name is showing right automatically. If when you type administrator, so it is automatically bottom, you can see your computer name. Now CTS to win C1 slash, okay. So now the sign into Vedic is changed to this one. Next, student one. Okay, and what is the password is Vedic at the rate 123. Now I am logging to my local account. That's why, guys, important things when you are dealing with the system: computer names, IP addresses, user names, passwords. You must remember. For starting, you can write down. Start write down on notes for the starting time. Okay, see. Do you remember all screen? I put a movies, pictures and all. This is my screen now. So I am login as a local account candidate. Okay, so not as a domain account. So this is how you can log into a local account. That's it.